Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group, and we're here to talk more in depth in terms of MIL-STD-810, and we're really focused on method 510 today, which is sand and dust. And essentially, what are you looking for in sand and dust testing, and what's the purpose of that test? Well, so that's looking at as material goes through your systems or settles on your systems. You're looking for mechanical problems where things jam up. You're looking for collection on heat sinks where this may impact the thermal performance. You're looking at abrasion. And so these are the kinds of things that you're trying to look at, both from the visual as well as the electrical performance, the mechanical performance of the system that you're trying to test. There's really two types of sand that's used in sand and dust, and there's three procedures that you use. So the first kind of sand or dust is a very, very fine talc. And that's primarily around 149 microns or less, and so that's that very, very, very fine silt talc material. And you heard a lot about this in Desert Storm and Desert Shield, where computers were getting filled up with this material, and they were starting to not perform thermally, or there were problems with the fans that needed to be replaced. And so you can design kits for that type of thing where they go on the front of the unit. The second type of sand or material that's used is typically 150 to 850 micron. And that is more of a fine sand. That's usually a silicon dioxide material. There's a red China clay or red China sand that they typically use as a common medium for this kind of testing. So the tests are generally done in, there's three procedures that you can do. Procedure one involves blowing dust, and that's usually a 6-hour test for the unit, and you're looking at a 1.5 meter per second to 10 meter per second type of a velocity for the dust. Blowing sand is procedure two, and that's in the range of 18 meters per second. Again, these are all tailorable. But that's generally a 90-minute test, whereas settling dust is, they do specify around 105 micron. There's really no airflow in that, and it's really a 3-day test. And so you're looking at the effects of either blowing dust, sand, or settling dust in this testing. All of these done at a room temperature and around 30% relative humidity. And then procedure three really is one of the procedures where that's settling dust, and you're looking for, you know, how long can the product sit in a dusty environment and just be settled. Any one of these tests, they're looking for at least a 10-minute operation at the end of the test, just to make sure that things are still functioning, filters are not clogged, things like that. As with all of the MIL-STD-810 testing, these parameters need to be tailored for the application. So there's quite a bit of tailoring associated with the testing. When you get done with a test, then you're looking for, does the unit perform to the specifications? Is there any visual damage? That kind of inspection is generally what's done for the final test article after you get done with the testing. So again, what are you looking for? Electrically, did you degrade? Thermally, did you overheat? Mechanically, do you see any visual abrasion or loss of paints or protective coatings? Anything that could cause damage to the system. And so that's generally what you're looking for sand and dust. And that's kind of just a quick summary of what it is the test is for and how you do it. Thanks a lot.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group. Mm-hmm.